Good morning. Today we're going to answer the question, does how you hold your feet affect how far you slide on a water slide?
Hey guys.
Hey, Bo.
Hi, Bo.
Flippin' physics.
The specific water slide we're talking about today is the Plunge Peak Green Slide at Rolling Hills Water Park. The question I'm asking is, which way of holding your feet will cause you to slide the farthest? Pointed feet, flat feet, or it won't make a difference?
No matter how you hold your feet, you're still going down the same slide, so I don't think it'll make a difference.
I don't know. I think how you hold your feet should make a difference. However, I just don't know which one will make you go farther.
I'm guessing that if you point your feet, you are more aerodynamic, and therefore you should go farther.
Yeah. Pointed feet is farther.
Okay.
Bobby, what does it mean to be more aerodynamic?
The more aerodynamic something is, the smaller the drag force is on the object.
Yeah, like a race car is more aerodynamic than a truck.
Correct. A race car is more aerodynamic than a truck, which means that a race car will have a proportionally smaller drag force acting on it. Let's take a look at the equation for drag force to see if it might also apply to foot position. We have actually already talked about the drag force equation and all of its variables in detail, so I'm just going to talk about it briefly here. The drag force is equal to 1/2 times the density of the medium. The medium would be, in the case of the water slide, the water. Times now the next three all have to do with the object. The object in the case of the water slide is me. So times the velocity of the object squared, times the drag coefficient of the object, times the cross-sectional area of the object. Now the question is, are these affected by a change in foot position? The density of the water, not affected by a change in foot position. The velocity of the object, the velocity of my body right before I get to the very bottom of the slide where the water is going to slow me down, is not going to be changed appreciably by a change in foot position. And the drag coefficient will change a little bit based on foot position, but what changes the most is the cross-sectional area. To remind ourselves of what cross-sectional area is, we are going to take a look at this block, which is in the shape of a cylinder. In case number one, when the block is moving in a direction parallel to its long cylindrical axis, the cross-sectional area that is perpendicular to the direction of its velocity is a circle whose area is pi times the radius squared, or pi times 1.5 centimeters squared, which is about 7.1 centimeters squared. And in case number two, when the block is moving in a direction perpendicular to its long cylindrical axis, the cross-sectional area, which is perpendicular to the direction of motion, is a rectangle whose area is the diameter of the circle times the length of the cylinder, or 3.0 centimeters times 13.9 centimeters, which is about 42 centimeters squared. Which means, because the cross-sectional area is smaller in case number one, like the race car, it is more aerodynamic, and there would be a much smaller drag force on the cylinder if it is moving like it is in case number one.
Which means I was correct. When you point your feet have a smaller cross-sectional area, which means the drag force is decreased, and therefore you should slide farther.
Right, because a smaller drag force will mean a smaller net force slowing you down, and therefore a smaller acceleration, which will mean that you'll slide farther.
And to be absolutely clear, this area is the cross-sectional area, which is perpendicular to the velocity of the object. Now let's watch me on the water slide. Is with my feet pointed, and the bottom video is with my feet flat. You can see that each time I point my feet, I end up sliding farther than when I have my feet flat. We actually measured four trials, and with my feet pointed, I slid about 15 meters, and with my feet flat, I slid about 12.5 meters. So it clearly makes a big difference. you slide about 20% farther when you point your feet. In fact, you can clearly see that when I point my feet, there is only a little water forced out of the slide. However, when I have flat feet, there is quite a big splash because the larger cross-sectional area has to push more water out of the way. Again, pointing your feet decreases the cross-sectional area, which decreases the drag force, which decreases the net force, and net force equals mass times acceleration, and therefore a decrease in net force will decrease the acceleration, which means that my body will slide farther. So, the correct answer is that pointing your feet will make you go farther.
Hold up, Mr. P. Let's go back to the cylindrical block.
Couldn't you have just dropped the cylindrical block into a tank of water and shown that with a smaller cross-sectional area, it'll go deeper into the water?
Yes. But it wouldn't have been nearly as much fun.
Yeah, there's that.
Thank you to Rhonda Petty, the park and facility supervisor who graciously allowed us to film at Rolling Hills Water Park. Also, thank you to Aaron Fawn of First UAV for using his unmanned aerial vehicle to provide video from above. Thank you to my family for helping with everything. And finally, thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.